यशोदानन्दन व्रज जनरञ्जन यशोदानन्दन व्रज जनरञ्जन नमो नतिरावनचारिणि यमो नतिरावनचारिणि जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारी
आचार्य सदृश श्रीमद हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस से भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्री प्रभुपाद जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रजकाचार्य सदृश श्री श्रीमद हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस भक्ति सिद्धांत श्री ठाकुर श्री प्रभुपाद अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद नामाचार्य श्री हरदास ठाकुर प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास आदि गौर भक्त वृंद श्री राधा कृष्ण गो गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय श्री वृंदावन मथुर धाम की जय मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जय पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय कलिग पावन श्री हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल डिवोट ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल डिवोट ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल डिवोट All glories, all glories, all glories to Shri Guru and Shri Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Naram Chaiva Narottamam. Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam. Tato Jayam Udiraye. नष्टप्रायेष्वभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नैष्टिकी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 12th Chapter 12th, Srimad Bhagavatam, summarize, verse number 3. Atra Sankirtitaha Sakshat Sarva Papa Haro Hari नारायणो ऋषिकेशो भगवान सत्वतां पति अत्र संकीर्तितः साक्षात् सर्वपापहरो हरि नारायणो ऋषिकेशो भगवान सात्वतां पति अत्र संकीर्तितः साक्षात् सर्वपापहरो हरि नारायणो ऋषिकेशो भगवान् सत्वतां पति word by word meaning atra here in the Srimad Bhagavatam sankirtita is fully glorified sakshat directly sarva papa of all sins hara the remover hari the personality of Godhead, Lord Hari, Narayana, Narayana, Rishikesha, Rishikesh, the Lord of the senses, Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality, Satvatam, of the Yadus, Pati, the master. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation: this literature fully glorifies the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, who removes all His devotees' sinful reactions. The Lord is glorified as Narayan, Rishikesh, and the Lord of the Satvatas. Purport: Lord Krishna's many holy names indicate His extraordinary transcendental qualities. The name Hari indicates that the Lord removes all sins from the heart of His devotee. Narayan indicates that the Lord sustains the existence of all other beings. Rishikesh indicates that Lord Krishna is the ultimate controller of the senses of all living beings. The word Bhagavan indicates that Lord Krishna is the all-attractive Supreme Being. And the word Satvatam Pati indicate that the Lord is naturally the master of the saintly and religious people, especially the members of the exalted Yadu family. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuran Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupaha Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarini Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namosate Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Bhescha Kripa Sindhu Bhevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktarunda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So welcome everyone for today's morning Srimad Bhagavatam class. So in this verse we see that Srila Suta Goswami is, in this chapter in fact, he is summarizing Srimad Bhagavatam. We are almost at the end of Srimad Bhagavatam. Yesterday our Srila Haridas Thakur was telling that it has taken almost how many? 26 years, he was saying, right? 26 years before this one round of Srimad Bhagavatam has been going on. It has taken almost 26 years, right? More than two decades. So, one way we should try to take the essence or hear it more attentively when it is being recited, irrespective of the speaker, because we never know that we will not get the second round. It may be the last round, and by the end of the second round we don't know whether we'll be existing in this material world or not, right? So better hear the Srimad Bhagavatam more attentively. And that will help us. Because it is not that how many times you hear. That is also important. But the quality of our hearing. How is the quality of our hearing? That also matters a lot, right? How we hear. And the theme has been going on. Effective communication. Radha Srila Radha Gopinath Prabhu, he started that on Sunday, New Year's beginning. Effective communication. How Suta Goswami, how is he is effectively communicating with his audience. What he is going to tell, before he tells, he is telling. While telling, he is telling what he is telling. And when he ends his narration, he's summarizing what he has told. And sometimes it is needed, because otherwise we get lost. What we are telling, why we are telling, what I am supposed to tell. We just get distracted. So therefore it is emphasized, it has been, it is the focus of our acharyas to keep us on the track. And we can see that this Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all scriptures. Amala Puran, it is the spotless Puran. Our acharyas have given the essence, everything in a crystallized form. We do not have to search anywhere else. And it is giving the absolute truth, the supreme absolute truth. It has been, that is the topic of Srimad Bhagavatam. It is not telling something relative truth. It is absolute truth. And the purpose of narrating Srimad Bhagavatam, right? Yasuta Goswami, we can see that he was there when Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken by Srila Shukadeva Goswami to Maharaj Parikshit for 7 days continuous, 7 days and seven nights. He was hearing and he attentively heard among so many other sages. He was hearing attentively. And now he is narrating to sages of Naimisharanya. Thousands of sages had gathered in Naimisharanya. And he had that special privilege of telling, reciting that Srimad Bhagavatam. And he had heard it attentively. Therefore he could repeat it. Isn't it? Shravanam Kirtanam. If we hear attentively, then we can repeat. Otherwise our hearing is sometimes mechanical or just selective hearing or just sometimes biographical hearing. We relate to ourselves. We don't reflect on it too much, why it has been told and how it is related to me personally. I should be hearing attentively. So Suta Goswami was having that kind of special privilege. And it could have been, he could have said that this Srimad Bhagavatam is now Suta Srimad Bhagavatam. It is my branding now, right? In today's time, everyone tries to brand their own names. Different types of yogas are also in different people's name. Yoga is original, right? But people are branding their own names. This yoga, that yoga. So Suta Goswami had that kind of authority. He could have done sutagoswami.com. And all his purports and commentaries, how many followers he has. He could have done that, but can understand how he has kept the purity intact. He's not adulterating anything. He's not mixing. Oh, this is my purport. What he heard, he's telling, right? Even if we go back at the beginning of Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva, he was a beginner. He was the first person. He was empowered to write literatures. He could have said that this is my Bhagavatam and it should be in my name always. This is my patenting. So much they could have told. But the main thing of the Acharya is that transparent vaya medium. They are not owning, they are not saying that this is mine. This is the message of Srimad Bhagavatam, this is the message of Godhead. I'm just an instrument in giving this message, right? So that is what is important to hear or to receive the knowledge in that parampara, right? Those who are thoroughly honest. Srila Narada Muni also, when there is a discussion between Srila Vyasadeva and Narada Muni, Narada Muni has been telling about the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. When Srila Vyasadeva had that kind of despondency, he was in a dilemma. He was feeling that there is something I have not written, something pinprick in his heart, some dissatisfaction that I have written so many literatures, but still there is something vacancy in my heart, right? I'm not feeling still satisfied. And Srila Narada Muni, who is the transcendental spaceman, as Srila Prabhupada says, universal preacher, he's going everywhere, identifying the inquisitive seekers and giving them this knowledge. He identifies the root cause of the problem. He understood that Srila Vyasadeva is not happy. They're sitting in that early morning on the banks of that, which river? Saraswati, right? Saraswati River, Shamyapras or somewhere. So they're sitting there, and we can understand the discussion and the level. Srila Narada Muni is the universal preacher. If we look at his life, three lifetimes before, he was a different person than previous life. And then how his life was transformed by serving Mahabhagavatas. So he has reached to that level. He's not an ordinary person. The way it is depicted in today's documentaries and movies is different. But if you look from the spiritual perspective, from the Bhagavatam perspective, he is a very exalted person. And Srila Vyasadeva was also a very empowered person. And he was, the most important qualification of Srila Vyasadeva was he was submissive. He was ready to hear. He received Srila Narada Muni and he understood that he has come here and I need to serve him, inquire submissively and try to resolve my conflict within. And he was putting forward, and he was also came to that kind of introspection that he has not glorified Supreme Lord. That kind of, he reached to that level, but he was not able to exactly identify, is this the real cause of my despondency? And Srila Narada Muni, he understood, and he told. In one way he said that literature which does not glorify the Supreme Lord. What is that literature? That is Vayasam Tirtham. That is a place of pilgrimage for crows. It's a very strong statement, right? Somebody is a very empowered person, he's writing so much, and he wrote in a different perspective, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. And so that is not very high level from the perspective of Srila Narada Muni, that you are again putting people in the conditioned state, right? Human form of life is so important. It is meant to get freed from the cycle of birth and death, right? In yesterday, our Srila Haridas Thakur was telling how important this human form of life is, story of turtle. And it is not that we had not heard that earlier. We had heard that. So many times we had heard that. But the way he was telling yesterday, we had to reflect again, right? That yes, this is why he's emphasizing so much. Because human form of life is important. But again, when it is repeated again and again, then we start understanding, yes, this is important. Because if we lose it without remembering the Supreme Lord, we don't know when we are going to get it. So better hear that. Better hear attentively. And transform our life, right? That is the main message. So here Srila Vyasadeva, he was hearing from Srila Narad Muni. And Srila Narad Muni was slowly he was entering into his heart and trying to remove all the blockages. Not the hard blockages. Hard blockages are easy to deal, right? But the mental blockages are more difficult to deal. Somebody has some block in the mind, very difficult to tell. You tell him Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, nothing is going to change. It requires lot of kind of attentive hearing. And person also should be willing to accept. The person is not willing to accept that this is my problem is getting addressed here. Right? Sometimes we hear and we also understand, he's maybe speaking my problem. And maybe I avoid this for 5 minutes and then some katha will come, then I will hear it. Sometimes we have some kind of selective hearing syndrome. But we should know that this is for me personally. Even while speaking also. So, Narad Muni, he was telling slowly, and he was telling that Tadvaga Visargo Janatag Viplav Yasmin Pratishlokam Abadhyavat Naman Yashunkitan Shunavanti Gayanti Grunanti Sadhava. So he was telling that literature which glorifies the Supreme Lord, even it may be imperfectly composed. That literature is glorified by the people who are thoroughly honest, right? So how important it is to glorify the Supreme Lord. And when we hear from such great souls as Srila Vyasadeva or Srila Narad Muni, how much it is powerful. And when the message is coming through the line of disciplic succession, then it is becoming more and more powerful. So therefore, we need to improve that kind of quality hearing. And that will actually help us. Because it is that moment when we decide to change our heart. Nobody can change from outside, right? But when we decide, okay, this is the way I should be now, looking in the from outside, from inside, how I should look at the world, how I should connect everything with the Supreme Lord. I have to change from within. Srila Vyasadeva also, he decided to change at that moment. That moment's association from the saintly person, like Srila Narad Muni, at that moment, when Srila Vyasadeva decided to transform from within, that is a very important moment, right? He understood, yes, this is my problem, and I need to humble myself. He could have counter-argued with Srila Narad Muni, oh, this is what you are saying, this, I have written so many literatures and why should I hear from you, right? Sometimes knowledge brings that kind of pride. But he had understood, no, this is, I need to resolve this controversy within. And here was the opportunity. He took that opportunity and heard that message. And therefore, we can see that when the heart of Srila Vyasadeva transformed, what happened? He wrote Srimad Bhagavatam, right? He was also there in the assembly of all the sages, Naimisharanya. Then he wrote that Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can understand when somebody follows the instructions of his spiritual master attentively, when he's hearing what is the mood of spiritual master, what he wants me to follow, what are the instructions, then that transformation can happen. And one will be empowered to execute the mission of spiritual master, right? And we can see that in our line also, when Srila Prabhupada, he met first his spiritual master. That time he was in liberation movement. Our country should get liberated first. That was the first priority of the nation. Entire country was behind getting liberation. And when he met his spiritual master, first time when he was just offering obeisances, his spiritual master gave him the lifelong mission. He told him that, you are an educated young person. You should take this message of Lord Chaitanya and preach in the Western world. Now this is a big, tall order. And here Srila Prabhupada was a householder, having family and so many other priorities in his life. And he had some kind of argument for some time. But then he understood what this sadhu is telling. He's not an ordinary sadhu. He had seen so many sadhus. And he was telling, in this so much political turmoil, he's telling that Krishna consciousness is the urgency. It cannot wait. People are suffering in this material world because they are not Krishna conscious. There are so many conflicts around. So many problems around, right? Today's time also we have, the whole entire world is affected by this pandemic. And if we tell that Krishna consciousness is urgency, who is going to listen, right? First they are waiting for the vaccine to come. First let the vaccine come, we get normal, right? But if we go deeply, we will realize that all these problems are coming because there is a lack of Krishna consciousness. There are some people who have their inferior motives, trying to control and become the economic power, and so many various ulterior motives are there. And therefore, when it is bloated up, it is blowing up, my country, my nation, my everything, it's centered around me, bodily conception of life, then the problems are becoming more and more severe. And then we can see that common people are suffering like anything, right? It's all the misidentification with this mortal body. But when we understand from the message of Srimad Bhagavatam that the first truth, we are not the material body, we are the spirit soul. We are all parts and parcels of Lord. And in that way, we are all brothers and sisters universally. So there is no need of fighting. Why one should fight? Why there should be discrimination? And it is all various material motives that has been, all divisions have been created. So therefore, it is important that how we hear the message, how we go more deep in the message of Srimad Bhagavatam. And then we'll see that the problems are negligible. They're not, but they are material problems. They need to be dealt in a different way. Otherwise, there can be fights amongst the devotees also sometimes, because of so many differences of opinion. I should be doing like this, and somebody says, no, I should be, it should be done like that. But if we put Krishna in the center, we see that whether I am pleasing my spiritual master, whether is it going to be pleasing to Lord Krishna, that is the higher purpose one should come. Where one should remain united at the higher purpose. Then all the differences can be resolved. So Kali Yuga, this 12th canto, describes the symptoms of Kali Yuga, right? And the Kali Yuga, how it is spreading like anything. Kali Yuga is spreading and it is creating divisions, right? It is dividing and rule. That is the policy of Kali Yuga. Divide and rule. Simple. Divide first, there was one nation. Now it is so many nations getting divided. So many differences of opinion. One country, there are some states, then states are getting divided. There are fights between among the states sometimes. Right? Isn't it? Border, this should, what we should get, and so many problems are there within. It's all Kali Yuga is actually trying to divide and rule, and it is the policy of Kali Yuga that everyone should be controlled in this way. Because when they are fighting amongst each other, Kali Yuga is going to spread, quarrel. And sometimes we see that within ourselves there are sometimes conflicts, right? Mind is fighting with intelligence. Right? What is right? Mind is sometimes trying to dominate like anything. Intelligence says, no, this is not good. Scripture says like this and it should not be done. Mind is so arrogant, so obstinate, so strong, difficult to control, right? That was a dilemma of Arjuna also. And so Kali Yuga has entered even within ourselves. And we are getting so much disconnected. So therefore, Srimad Bhagavatam brings everyone together. We need to come together, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. And we should try to go more deeper. The message of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then it will be, we can see the transformation. Within ourselves. We'll understand, yes, the medicine is working. I may not like to take the medicine. But this is a remedy for solving the problems of Kali Yuga. And we can see that we have been given so much. So many years we have been hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, Kathas, so many speakers are speaking. Kirtans are going on. Yatras, prasadam, books, so many temples. The whole purpose of the entire process is to transform our heart, right? In spite of all these, our heart is not getting transformed. If our attitude is not changing, we are not developing that service attitude, humble service attitude, then it is not so much of use. Otherwise, we may use everything in our own service, right? God is there to help us. But are we serving God? Or are we using God in our own service? That is the question. That is how our consciousness is working. our consciousness, every moment we have opportunity to serve. Or we can take service from others, where we decide to focus. If we decide to focus on service, serving devotees, serving the Supreme Lord, then we have ample opportunity. But when the mind tries to shift our attention and focus ourselves, focus on our own self, then it becomes completely different consciousness, right? And therefore, even the God is in front of us, we are not able to recognize. Srila Prabhupada tells one nice story in this regard. There was one old lady, and she was carrying some bundle of sticks on her head, and she was walking, and she stumbled upon, and all the sticks fell, all the bunch fell and scattered. And she was crying, "Oh, hi, hi, hey Bhagwan, what has happened? Please help me." And Bhagwan came, the Lord came in front of her. "Mataji, how can I help you? How can I help you?" So she said, "Oh, yeah, okay, you please gather all the sticks and put on my head again." So, Srila Prabhupada explains that God came to help this lady, right? She was struggling with so many anarthas and carrying so much of bundle of anarthas on her head. And God scattered that everything. Don't carry all this anartha on your head. God disposes everything. And that is one way of God's intervening in our life. He baffles our plan. "You won't have so many material desires, I will just smash you." And suddenly we feel, "Oh, why this is happening?" And we cry and we pray to the Lord. And when the God comes in front of us, we tell, "Oh God, give me all these material desires again." God is smashing all your material desires. He doesn't want you to get material entangled. And when the God comes, the holy name comes, when we are chanting, we are saying, "God, at least one desire. One, fulfill my one desire. I want to become like this. At least one department I should be heading." Right? So God is trying to teach that you are the servant of the servant. Become 100 times servant of this. But we don't want to hear from him. Right? We want everyone to hear from us. And we want that huge burden on our head. Right? It is so difficult. I mean, this is a very simple story Srila Prabhupada told. But when I was going deep and understanding the message, it's a deeper message that we are doing the same things. When the God comes, when we are chanting, we should be praying to the Lord. "Please, God, may give me your service. Please engage me in your devotional service." Right? But if we are not attentive, we are telling God, "Oh God, you do service for me. Fulfill my desires. Make me temple president." Oh, sorry. So... these are all churning while chanting. We have to watch our mind, our motivations. What we are praying actually, what we are doing, are we chanting properly? So, chanting can give benediction within a moment. You can liberate from within a moment. You can become liberated, free from the cycle of birth and death eternally. But we tell Lord, "Please, wait a moment. Don't give me immediately everything. I have still some preaching to done, preaching to theory. I want to reach out to more and more people, right? So please fulfill those desires first." So many, I mean, these are various types of thoughts we go through. Man ki baat. So, we need to go more deeply in our sadhana, our morning programs, and what morning program is actually a very good way of introspection, right? We need to really introspect. Mangala Arati, Narasingha Arati, Tulsi Puja, Japa, Bhagavatam. We need to really introspect and all. Give our time, quality time to ourselves. This should be our New Year's resolution. Right? I mean, it's already old. But still, every day is a new year, right? We should consider in that way. Every moment is a new moment. So we can think in that way. We should practice in that way. That morning program is a good time to introspect myself. How many anarthas I had in the previous year? What I did in my last year to overcome the anarthas? And how many anarthas I will have in the next year? Are we trying to increase the load, or are we trying to reduce that? Every year we should feel light. Slowly, slowly, we should reduce the burden. Should not do this. This weed should not increase. Anartha should not increase. We should try to minimize every year. Srimad Bhagavatam, we should take it more serious. Because Srimad Bhagavatam tells the truth that although we have the opportunity, we have been given that, every day we should listen and we should feel that, yes, now it is helping and I should become more serious. But Srimad Bhagavatam tells another perspective also, that every rising and setting of the sun, we are closer to death. That is also a message of Srimad Bhagavatam. We are coming closer to death and ultimately we'll have to face that time, that moment when we are face to face with the death, the ultimate reality. And are we ready for that? Are we ready? Are we ready to go now? Or we still have that so many anarthas, bundles of material desires on our head? So we need to introspect. And we need to pray to the Lord that I am helpless. So many anarthas are troubling me, they're like a vicious cycle. They're just growing in my heart. Please remove all those. And please engage me in your service. I should not asking any service from you. But please engage me in your service. Oh Lord, oh Gopinath. So in this way, when Krishna sees that we are sincerely praying, because Krishna also knows whether it is ordinary tears or real tears, are we sincerely praying or just we are showing that I am praying, I am a very nice devotee from outside. So we have to sincerely pray to the Lord that yes, please let this material desires get over. And let me become serious about Krishna consciousness. Let me take the message seriously. Let me serve the devotees. So much opportunity to serve in the mode of servant, in the Srila Prabhupada's mission. Let me try my best and still not develop pride within. Because the pride can be more serious anartha. It can disturb our main devotional creeper. And then again we will start offending the devotees and will not be even in the association of devotees. So Maya will try to disturb. She will make sure that you are thoroughly humble. Then only you will be that door of spiritual world will be open. So therefore, we need to take this message more seriously, more sincerely. And whoever is the speaker, we should hear that very, very attentively. And here the last things are coming up as Srila Sukadeva Goswami is ending the Srimad Bhagavatam. He's giving the hint. He is giving the hint of glories of the holy name, glorifying the Supreme Lord. because so much has been told. And now he's trying to give the essence, right? Because Kali Yuga is such a difficult age. We do not, sometimes we may not get even 7 days like Avish Parikshit Maharaj got to hear Bhagavatam. And even if we get, what is our quality of hearing? How much attentive will be? Will be just so much an anxiety over death is coming. So he's giving the essence. He's telling the chanting of the holy name. He's just giving the indications. The names, Lord is glorified as Narayan, Rishikesh, and the Lord of the Satvatas. Lord is glorified in the form of the holy name. Nama Chintamani, Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigra, Purna Shuddha Nitya Mukta, Abhinnatvam Nama Nami. It is explained that this holy name is Chintamani. It fulfills all our desires. And it is the open secret. It is available to everyone. The same holy name is available to everyone. But how we take it, how we attentively practice that, that depends on the sadhak. So one disciple asks his guru that, what is the secret of bhajan? What is the main secret? How we should worship the Lord? And he told that the chanting of the holy name, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram, Hare Hare. This is a Mahamantra, you should chant this Mahamantra. So he said, okay, this is nice. Then he was traveling, he was in the city, he was traveling. He saw that there were some washermen. They were chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra while washing their clothes and doing their activities. Then he thought that, oh, these people are also chanting this Mahamantra. What is secret about it? Then he went ahead and there were some girls, they were handling this cow dung and making that patties, and they were chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. He was thinking, oh, these girls also, they knew Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So what is the secret about it? So then he decided to come back to his ashram. In the rickshaw he saw it, and rickshaw wala was chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So he was thinking, what is the secret about this Mahamantra? This dhobi wala, I mean the washerman, and the rickshaw wala, and this girl. Everyone knows about the chanting of Hare Krishna. So he came back to Guru and said that, what Mahamantra you are given? What is the secret? Everyone knows this Mahamantra. So he told, okay, what you can do, you take this. He gave a precious jewel. And he told him that you go to these people and ask them how they will use that, what is the price they will pay. So he got a very precious jewel and he went to this washerman and said that, what price you will give me for this? So he said, what is this? This is a nice stone, I will wash clothes with this stone. So he said, give me back my jewel. Then he went to these girls. They saw this stone, they said, wow, so nice stone. We'll make these cow dung patties with this. It will make a nice shape and all. He said, no, give me back. Took that stone again. Then he went to Rikshawala. And Rikshawala said, oh, it's such a nice stone. It's very little rough also. And I will use this to scrape my feet. So he said, no, nothing doing. Give me. And he took that and came back to his guru again. And guru told, see, now you understood. This is a precious jewel, right? But who is ready to pay the price for it? They don't know the value of this precious jewel. They're using it for their ordinary purpose, their own material purpose they're using, right? One who knows the value of this precious jewel, he will pay the price. So similarly, the holy name is that Nama Chintamani, the holy precious jewel which our acharyas have given. And to get that, to realize its value, we need to perform the sadhana bhakti, chanting attentively, hearing Bhagavatam, serving the devotees, worshipping the deities. Then we'll realize what my guru has given. Otherwise, the chanting becomes like a huge burden, right? The feedback becomes very heavy when we are not in the mood to chant. So therefore, I will end now, it's getting over. So therefore, this is the essence. Our acharyas have given the essence, and Srila Swata Goswami also very nicely summarizing the Srimad Bhagavatam and coming towards the end of Srimad Bhagavatam, where he is giving the formula, the shortcut formula of the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.